All right, guys. I'm going to talk about a few different things today. I haven't been on in a while. I haven't really been doing this, like actually sitting on here and talking for a while. Just been doing a lot of playing, which is funny because, when the whole Scott Grove thing was going on, everyone's like, "Just want to hear you play, blah, blah, blah. Just play, just play, just play." Since I've been playing, half as many people have been talking. People love drama. People love shit going on. So, to keep with that tradition, I've been getting some shit recently. And I know it's fucking Scott. I'm not stupid. There's been like 16 different accounts that have come on, said the same sort of shit. Same old, "You suck," or "You're terrible," or "Scott's better," or something like that. Yeah, it's pretty obvious that it's Scott because, for one, he's been caught doing that on other sites and stuff before. Like, people know that he's done that. And two, I mean, these accounts are like brand new accounts, no activity on them, no videos, no like things, no subscriptions, nothing. They're just some stupid name and boom, made. So, I mean, that's pathetic, man. That's like setting aside some like really pathetic time to go out of your way to try to do something. I don't understand it. It just doesn't make any sense to me, but I know it's him, so you can keep doing it if you want, dude. I don't see the point. It's just ridiculous to me. But other than that, was gonna talk about this fucking sucks. Oh yeah, wait. I'll go to this first. And for the other people that have made videos about me and shit, stupidest crap ever. Oh my god. Okay. Like, in your videos, you're always saying it's a waste of time and shit like this. Wouldn't you think it would be a waste of time to fight someone else's battle? Because, I'm talking about Scott Grove, talking to Scott Grove, and, you people are coming from the outside of me, but you're on the inside with him because you're obviously his fans. Duh. And you're basically, trying to fight his battles for him. Wouldn't you think that's more of a waste of time? And more of like just stupidity, like, honestly? Because for one, I'm not gonna care because obviously you're his fans. And I've stated numerous times that his fans don't mean shit to me. I mean, if you are his fan, you are a shitty person. That just, you can't be his fan and not be. Because if you listen to what he says and listen and watch the things he does and things he talks about and how he talks to people, how he talks about things, what he does, there's no way you could listen to all that and actually like him. It's just insane. Like, you people are terrible people. But, I've shown that in my, that was pretty much, a perfect point to my entire thing to show how shitty all you guys are is all the shit that you wrote after that. You know what I mean? Oh my God, it was just ridiculous. But, yeah, like that fag grinder, butt grinder, ass kisser or whatever the fuck his name, I don't know what the hell his name is, on there made a video about me. That was a Jesus, man, just blowing hot air the entire time. Nobody can hear what the fuck you're saying because some buzzing's going on the entire goddamn video. Looks like shit. That guy's an idiot. Talk to him. It was just like, dude, you didn't listen to anything I said, which 99.999% of the time, the people that don't like me didn't listen to anything I actually fucking said. Most people take what they want to hear out and, throw that against the wall. Like, that's all they said. It's like, you gotta listen to shit. If you're gonna come out and make a fucking opinion about something, listen to it. Listen. See, this is the problem. This is why you guys like Scott Grove in the first place. It's because you guys are too stupid to actually listen to things that he says to realize that he's a shitty person. My point is pretty much proven right there. It's just, it's laid out for you. But anyways, so if anyone is a Gwar fan, you'd know that, you know, a few years ago, their guitar player, had died on tour from a heart attack, apparently. Now, this is what bums me out. The singer, the founder of the band, has now died just recently. Very recently. And it just breaks my heart, man. Like, that guy was the coolest dude. So funny. Even if you guys don't like their music, which I'm not a huge fan of their music anyway. Like, I don't really give a shit about the music. The band, live, is just the funnest thing to watch. It was hilarious. Like, oh my god, so funny. And just everything he said in interviews, look up Gwar interviews, you'll laugh your ass off. They're hilarious. The guy was just a comedic genius, just funny as hell. He took his character to the nines. It was perfect. But yeah, he died, so pretty sure that band's over, because he's the one who created the band in the first place. Really bums me out. There's been a lot of really good musicians that have died recently. And it's just sad when you lose that kind of talent and that kind of, you know, character that they portray on stage, you know. Because, you know, to the mere millions, you know, these rock stars are gods to certain people, you know. You forget that they're actually human sometimes. And then shit like that happens. It's like, damn. And they're really gone. Like, I'm never going to get to see them play. Nothing. It just sucks. So, yeah, rest in peace to him. Other than that, recently, yeah, I haven't been doing a whole lot of videos. I've been doing some, you know, guitar playing videos, like cover videos and stuff. But, like, as far as, you know, one-on-one videos like this, I haven't really been doing it lately. I've been busy doing all sorts of different shit and trying to get just everything in life situated. Try to figure where I want to go and, you know, how I'm going to get something going, you know, musically. Try to find some other musicians that are, you know, as passionate about it as I am. So, that shit, you don't just run into that shit all day, like every day. I mean, yeah, people can be passionate about music but have not one lick of talent. I mean, look at most of Scott Grove's fans. I mean, that's that's pretty much proof right there. But anyways, I worked on my amp, my PV XXX. Got it some new tubes. They need to be broken in, for sure. It sounds really good. I mean, don't get me wrong. But it's just, I don't know. When the tubes get broken in right, they got this more of a, like a, just a guttural crunch to it. And it just, I don't know. It's a little too smooth for my liking. I like some fucking just nasty, ugly, freaking crushing distortion. I think that's kind of what I go for. So, riffs I've been writing have been really, really weird. I think I'm onto something. So hopefully I get to start hopefully recording some of this stuff pretty soon. And then, release it at some point. But, got that all fixed up. Tune some of my guitars. One thing before I go on to what I've done with my guitars. On the subject of getting that shit talking from, you know, Scott and his fans and stupid people. I keep getting the same shit. People talking shit about me wearing a hat and people talking shit about me doing that. Okay. I have a deviated septum. Only one of my nostrils works. So when I'm talking, especially when I'm doing videos and stuff, I'm having to breathe through my nose, and that's why I do that. My nose is just destroyed. It's been broken so many fucking times, I can't even remember. But that's why I do that. And as for my hat, it's because my fucking hair is growing out. If any of you have ever grown out your hair, you know that when it gets to the length that mine's at right now, where it's about hanging to your nose, it's fucking annoying because it just sits in your face and it's not long enough to pull back. It's not really long enough to, you know, tuck fully behind your ears and shit, so it's fucking always in your face. That's why I wear my hat. Hopefully it'll start spurting out longer pretty soon. Fuck, man, it feels like it's taking forever. And relatively, no. I mean, I just started growing my hair out right around when I started making these videos, and it's already, you know, that long, so. But I've always had super long hair. I just cut it, like, like 2 years ago and had it short for a while, but I've always been a dude with really long hair, so I'll get back to where I've always been. Anyways, this is what I've done with this. And this, it's funny, because the markers on this guitar, particularly, were really small, just little dots, and they weren't, like, very prominent white dots. They're pretty dim. So, like, on stage, you know, in dark rooms and stuff, I could never see where the fuck I was at. I just kind of had to feel, you know, kind of. And that was one reason, you know, I became so accustomed to this guitar, because most of the time live, I was having to play blind, so I had to play, you know, out of feel. Like, and I know this guitar backwards and forwards. Like, I know everywhere on it. So, I went and I used fucking white fingernail polish enamel. That's all I used. And it's been staying on there really good. I don't even notice it when I'm playing either. You just gotta make sure you're careful with it. You don't get it all over the, you know, top of the fretboard and all of your strings or something. But I just kind of put it up and let it dry. And it's been on there for a while now. I thought that was a cool thing. I saw that another guitar player did that for a little bit. First, he did it with tape, which I tried that, and I could feel it all the time, and I fucking hated it. So I did it with the toenail polish or whatever, fingernail polish. And works. Works great. And I was changing the strings on my Jackson. This is the last story I wanted to tell you. Kind of end this little deal. I'm sure this has happened to other people, but this many times in a row, oh man, I was pulling my fucking hair out of my head. Changing the strings on my Jackson, the one with the Floyd Rose, it's just a bitch. And I was changing tunings too, so I had to change string size, and then I had to reset the action and reset, you know, the tension, everything. I had to go through the whole thing and pretty much redo it from the ground up, because when you change your tuning on a Floyd Rose, you have to change everything. It's not just one thing. You don't just drop it down and it's all good. No, you have to change everything. So I did that, and when I put on my high E string, get it up first time, get it up, and I, you know, go to bend it, you know, to cut out the, get it so it stretches itself out, you know, and snap one string, I'm like, fuck, comes back and hits me in the finger, because it was at full tension. I was like, shit. I actually still have the little cut, I don't know if you can see, on my finger, or on the tip, but, anyways, so I put another one on. I had to get one out of another pack, which pissed me off in the first place. You know, put that one on, tune it up, go to bend it again, snaps again. I'm like, what the fuck? So, you know, had to go through and take steel wool, get it on a little end of something tiny and kind of get inside there and smooth it all out and smooth out the edges and stuff. Took three sets, three different sets that I had to pull out the high E string from. Fuck, man, I was so mad. Just for one damn guitar that I play half as much as my others. Fuck, man. That's why I changed the tuning on it. Hopefully, you know, I can integrate it more, but I don't, you know, whatever. Blah, blah, blah. So, yeah, once again, to all my haters, see that? It's magic. It flew in from out here. Bam. I don't care about the shit talking, it's whatever. If you think I suck, post a video of yourself, and we can all determine who's better. If you want to do that. That shit is so stupid. Just to go on someone's page and just go, you suck. I mean, okay. Thanks for, you know, giving your really heartfelt, in-depth fucking review of my playing and stuff. Thanks for that. But people are just assholes. You don't really realize how many shitty people are in this world until you start making videos on YouTube like this. Huh. Good God. There's some people that just need to not be around anymore. Yes. So, you guys, keep rocking. Keep hitting me up for shit. You know, talk, ask me questions. Whatever you need to know, do my best to answer you. I always do answer people, I think. I think I've answered pretty much everyone that's, you know, asked me questions for the most part. I mean, if I can just answer it from you guys commenting or a message or something, if I can just answer it there, I always do. If you guys ask for a video or something, then I make videos and stuff. But, you know, usually if I can just answer it quick, I'll do that. But, yeah, just get at me. And, keep rocking.